nyama bagi
Chihuahua.
Expedition February 2016.
Jumbo!
Hi, Daniel.
Jumbo.
Jumbo, what is that?
Hello in Swahili.
Swahili. Ah, that's what they speak in Tanzania.
Yeah.
Did you learn a lot of Swahili while you're in Tanzania?
Yeah, many. Kwaheri is bye. Asante is thank you. And asante sana is thank you very much. Zabari is how are you? Hakuna Matata is no problem. And PP is sweets, which the kids used to say when we passed by them.
So Diego, could you tell us a little bit about the food and the facilities and what they were like at Camp Shamba Kipara?
Oh, well, the food was amazing because we had basically three hot meals a day. And in camp, we usually had a kind of international food. But when we went to the orphanage and we ate there, it was very local. And we had local fruits and it was really good. And then the facilities, they were also pretty good because the tents were, they had nets, so mosquitoes, we didn't have to worry about them. And also after a long day's work in the sun, in the hot weather, there was a pool so you could swim around. So it was great.
And where exactly was the camp located?
The camp was located really in the middle of nowhere, basically, in a very small remote village.
And was it close to any city at all?
Yeah, it was close to...
Was it called Arusha?
Yeah, Arusha.
Great. So, Eugenia, could you tell us what you did while you were in Tanzania?
Okay, so Tanzania was divided into, the trip was divided into three different activities. Two of the activities were voluntary work, and the other one was a safari, which was the last days. The voluntary work was, the first activity was making goat sheds and putting electricity into people's houses, and also making smokeless stoves. And then the other task was, activity, was building the teacher's accommodation center for, and we were putting bricks and plastering the, for the, in order for the school to have the teachers closer. For me, the best activity was putting the electricity because it's really crazy thinking how they live without light. And when the woman's house where we put the light, when she turned, pressed the button and the light went on, it was really amazing, her face and how she was shocked.
So Macarena, could you tell us about the safari?
Well, in the safari, we went to the Tarangire National Park. It took us 4 hours from the camp, and we went on this huge truck with other people from another school. And it was open, so we could. There was a ceiling, we could see over the top and all the animals and everything. It was really cool.
What kind of animals did you see on the safari?
We saw lots of elephants, giraffes, ostriches, lions, and my favorite one were the lions because it was really amazing to see a lion so close.
And how long was your safari?
2 days. We slept there. And it was really a cool experience.
So Antonio, could you tell us what the highlight of your trip to Tanzania was?
I think the highlight of my trip was meeting new cultures, meeting new people from all around the world, and seeing how they kind of live in their cultures and their societies.
And in Tanzania, was there anything that called your attention?
Yes, how the people lived, how they interacted with each other, how they traded with one another.
And did they have many resources?
No, they did not have many resources.
And yet they seemed happy, huh?
Yes.
So Mikaela, could you tell us about the sounds and smells that come to mind when you think of Tanzania?
I have two sounds that come to mind, and the first one is the call to prayer that woke us up every morning at 5 a.m. when we were in our tent sleeping, and also the sound of the rain falling on the tent, on top of the tent, the first night that we were there. It was really nice, or at least for me, it was really nice.
And what types of smells?
Some people work with cow poop, so that was a smell that was pretty memorable. But yeah, and also the lemon cookies that they served at the camp.
Ah, those were good. Yes. Hi, Brian.
Hello.
Was there a funniest moment on your trip to Tanzania?
The funniest moment was when we were on safari, and we had stopped for a break, and Macron and his apple got taken by a blue testicled monkey. And that's not the funniest bit. The funniest bit was when, a blue-balled monkey actually climbed up a tree and peed on the table, and that was pretty funny.
You can watch the video of the blue-balled monkey on the school website.